Triple C in Somerset has been working as part of the wider Hills to Levels initiative. Our efforts have been targeted to slow the flow to reduce flooding and soil erosion. We've worked with farmers, land managers and local stakeholders through one-to-one advice, demos and focus groups. We've also provided capital grants for water retention and erosion control measures.
Well, hello folks, here we are at Folly Farmyard in a little hamlet of Dommett in the parish of Buckland St Mary. It was a few years ago that Joanna and Sabine came knocking on my gate and told me about this project. We had a good old walk around and agreed a plan. Within no time at all, we were in action and we got the digger in, and here we are at an old farm pond that would have been here a couple of hundred years ago when they were building the farm. We dug it out much as we thought it might have been years ago. Here we are in August and the level, as you see, has dropped right down, but in the middle of winter it's full up with water and it's overflowing the sluice. Got a little bit of control over there at the sluice, so we can adjust the levels if we need to. We can let water out. And then over the farm we've got various other scrapes and leaky dams that are working quite well. There's nothing massive here on the farm, it's all fairly small measures, but it's really important that we're a small part of a really big jigsaw, and we are really making a difference to the amount of water that goes down onto the levels. We're holding quite a lot back.
The work to slow the flow at Folly Farmyard has been completed through the Hills to Levels project with funding from the Somerset Rivers Authority and Triple C.
Over the last 3 years, we have been monitoring a range of natural flood management measures through the Hills to Levels project. These range from leaky woody dams, floodplain attenuation ponds, and these brush dams and bunded scrapes. And from the monitoring, we have seen that during moderate rainfall events, the brush dam is able to hold back water and then push it into these bunded scrapes.
Monitoring has shown that woody dams can store water and also create important habitats and channel shape diversity. From the results, we've learned that each dam stores only a small amount of water, and for best results, they should be designed to spread high flows onto the floodplain.
So this is right down against what's become known as George's Gorge, which is is the road going down to the river. And this is actually an area there with the road where there was a real danger of a landslip, and there've been landslips in the past. Yeah, they have, quite serious ones. So this was going to stabilise and suck up the moisture, and that's the reason for planting it, really, apart from the fact we like woodland.
In the Williamsbrook catchment, we've worked with the local flood wardens. They bring enthusiasm and dedication and the local knowledge to work with us. Many of the sites are different techniques and measures which we've trialled in this catchment, and they bring a lot of knowledge to other people and other catchments.
My name is Marvin Collins. I'm a resident of the hamlet of Lufton. Facilities like this here, where I can store water by coming down and opening the sluices before the storm arrives, emptying it so on a lowering tide it bridge water. I can then shut this one and I've got an area that can hold back a spate.
Part of the work involved commissioning a modelling study within the Williamsbrook catchment. We wanted to see what sort of impact the water retention measures we've installed could have on the flood hydrograph. The results suggested that for a 1 in 5 year event, the peak could be reduced by 25%. It's important to note that these are modelled calculations, so we've been working with Bristol University, who have been monitoring these sites and looking at real-time events.
So I'm a PhD student at Bristol University, looking at the effectiveness of natural flood management in Somerset. So as part of this, I'm monitoring a range of field sites that have natural flood management structures, this being one of them. It's really interesting how you can see the attenuation that's happened as a result of these ponds, because obviously each one have an outflow gauge that can be controlled by the flood wardens, so kept open or closed or halfway. You can clearly see the peak volume at this upstream pond that happens at a certain time, but then the peak doesn't happen downstream for another 4 hours or so.
The project has been match funded by the Somerset Rivers Authority, which has helped us deliver more in our catchment area. The SRA were keen to support us because Triple C is about catchments, communities and climate change, which is in line with their efforts to deliver the Somerset 20-year flood action plan. Triple C has given us the opportunity to develop techniques and knowledge in natural flood management by working with project partners and local communities. Flood wardens we've supported and the farmer focus groups we've set up have given key people the knowledge, contacts and resources to make a difference in their area. Within these networks, we're sure that activities will span beyond the lifetime of the Triple C project.